Good morning, children. Today we are going to discuss very interesting properties of factors and multiples. Now here I have written some factors of numbers like 4. It is having the factors 1, 2, 4, factors of 10, factors of 24 and factors of 36. The very first property that we are going to discuss is, if we look for all the factors of these numbers, 1 is there in each of the numbers. So we can say 1 is the factor of every number. So the first property we have, 1 is the factor of every number, because we see 1 is appearing in the factors of all these numbers. Secondly, if we look for the factors of 4, the number itself is appearing in the factors. For 10, 10 is also there in its factors. For 24, 24 is a factor of 24. And 36 is also a factor of 36. So the second property we can have, every number is the factor of itself.
Answer after addition is coming double the given number. 6 into 2,
12, 28 into 2, 56. So, if I say that if you add sum or if you add all the factors of the given number and the sum is coming twice the given number, then that number is called a perfect number. So, according to the definition, if sum of all the factors of given number is twice the given number, then the number is called a perfect number. So we have here two examples. 6 and 28 are two perfect numbers. Now let us do some properties of multiples of a given number. I have written some multiples of 5, 7 and 10. You look for the multiples of 5, it begins with 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 and so on. Of 7, it begins with 7 and of 10, it begins with 10. So here we look, the first property of multiples of any number is the every multiple of a given number is either equal to or greater than the given number. So I write every multiple of a number is either equal to or greater than the number. Secondly, if I start with 5 and keep on writing the multiples, there are endless multiples for every number. Here I have stopped at 30, but you can write as many as multiples as you want. In case of 7 also, in case of 10 also, and in case of any other number you want to find the multiples. So, multiples of any number are infinite. Now children, in case of factors, we have seen the factors are finite, but in case of multiples, they are infinite. That means they are uncountable. The third and the last property is, in each case you can see, in the case of 5, 5 is a multiple of itself, 7 is a multiple of 7, 10 is a multiple of 10. So we can have one another important property, every number is a multiple of itself. So here we have done three properties of multiples. Every multiple of a number is either equal to or greater than the number. Second, multiples of any number are